Okay, gentlemen, so let us continue back. Sorry for the interruption of the technical problem just now. So we have the ARA, ARB, SIA, SIB, VVA, VVB, and so on. All these things actually reflect with our questionnaire, right? So I might want to open the questionnaire for you so that you can see it is the... we call it as an index learning style questionnaire, right? So based on this knowledge and based on these matrices, we already understand that they have a few columns. So the ARA just now that you see in this file actually reflect with this column, okay? But it is in the row basis because it is representing by each of the individual personnel that already being recorded here. You see, this is their score, okay, for the ARA as a total, which is comprises of question 1 until 41, and then followed by the following details. And then after that, under the algorithm of using this questionnaire, they said that the larger minus the smaller. So I'm not doing that actually, so I'm just doing it in a robust manner where we ask the SPSS syntax to just compute the differences. So that's why I put it here as ARF, means that the activist and reflective final data that already being come out here as a basis of the numbers, you see. This is the numbers that already being recorded here. We got the 5, minus 5 and 6 and so on. Actually, we need to translate what is the 5 and then straight away we know already. This one is 5, this one is minus 5. So actually they have two strong component with regard to the activist reflector and also, sorry, AR, yeah, and also SI, which is the sensing and intuitive component. Okay, without further ado, let us have a look about the classification after that. We measure the classification using the intermediate final recode here. Because I just want to identify the positive and negative, because the positive will reflect to this side or giving the reflector. If negative, it's talking about this activist. Same also goes to this. If I saw some sort of negative values, it is indicate visual, and then positive indicate a verbal. After doing that, then I'm coming up with the new methods actually, where we classify everything according to the classification given here, you see, score 1 to 3, 5 to 7, 9 to 11. So by doing that, actually, I can sort of make a few classification here, activist low, activist medium, high, reflection medium, reflection low, and so on. So if you want to know more, you can comment in the down below. So after that, I already capture all these activist, medium, intuitive medium, visual low, and global low. But that is not our purpose, because in the end of the day, our purpose, we want to know which following 1, 2, 3, 4 will stand up and give us only one item. So actually, if you can see here, it is not fulfilling any high category, because our last mechanism we stated here as whoever classified as 3, 3 is actually highest activities, lah, which is 9 to 11, which is strongly associated with that dimension. It is not classified here. However, we also rerun again using the medium classification method, also we can get this value. However, all this value is already being generated automatically using SPSS by run the syntax that I already prepared just now. We cannot classify it nicely. Therefore, we have to copy it back and then use the catnate function under the Microsoft Excel. So now we can already visualize. Let's say ID number 6 is dimension visual, and then we got the final details. Okay, if you got these two, for example, activist and visual, so you might want to consider to have a look back their questionnaire and so on. But the individual basis of the answer is a very good findings that we want. However, there are so many empty spaces here that come up with the final two. Final two is actually the AR2. This one located here where I analyze by individual of final two, which is we also count those who are activist 2. Activist 2 means that the scoring of the medium here, 5 to 7. Therefore, the final should be identified soon by the finalized of the final, which is we have to sort of identify whether you want to choose activist or intuitive, because both are similar to 2, which is medium, right? But this one, of course, it is confirmed, it is a visual. This one, if you can see here, there's nothing here, only intuitive 2 and visual 2. So it's intuitive, and this one also is visual, okay? But this one is none because it is not well identified by all those criteria. Okay, that is the idea of using the ILI, or we call it as Index Learning Style Questionnaire. So hopefully you find out this video useful, and please don't forget to subscribe, comment and share this video. If you got any comment, please do comment down there. If you want to have a look about the detail of the syntax and workshop, please let me know, because we are trying to have a sharing session about how to create these challenging syntax details in our data analysis. With that, thank you very much. See you again. Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum and very good evening.